Hi, Herman Williams here. We're in part two today of our video series on how to create more speed, power, and distance in golf. In part one, if you missed it, we talked a lot about grip. I had kind of my short club I've used in some other training videos that I have. We talked about how basically you're going to generate more speed, power, and distance if you can get more leverage, which would be more wrist hinge with lag. And then the body component that would bring in kind of hip speed and body rotation. So we're kind of looking at it from, you've got to max out what you can do with your hands and arms, and then max out what you're going to be able to do with your body. And you know, first video, we really just dealt only with the grip and then how to create that sensation of lag in the top of the backswing. Today, we'll deal a little bit more with transition and some of the body component on how to generate some of that extra speed and how to maintain some of that lag. So let me get rid of this little short club, and we'll get a longer club in here, and I'll back away from the camera here for a second. So in video one, we got you a little bit stronger left hand, weaker right hand. We did that because that's anatomically neutral and will give you the maximum amount of wrist hinge. So we're going to assume you have that squared away. We talked about takeaway in the early portion of the takeaway, fairly one-piece start, creating a lot of width as we move away from the golf ball. Now, at around the waist-high area, we talked about we were going to begin to push down on the handle. We're going to kind of lever right here as we start to hinge the wrist, and the sensation would be the right arm will fold down as we point the handle away from us and create a lot of width right here. Now there's a couple of features you want to look at as you're doing that. The right leg, and again we're assuming right-handed golfers here, but as we think about right leg position, as we would get into the setup, the feet will be wider than the hips, so it creates a little outward flare to the legs. And as we coil into the backswing, we want to keep a leaning angle here. In fact, let me go back to the computer. I'll show you a couple of quick positions here that you can think about. This is Jamie Sadlowski, long drive competitor. Look at a couple of key things. If we looked at, talked about things from video one, look in the left wrist right there. He's actually got a cupped wrist. And I know that many of you have seen my video. I have a video out there that's very popular that talks about a flat left wrist. That's basically to get you more control. If you need distance, we're going to have to use a stronger grip and create some cupping in that wrist to get hinge. But look at the amazing angle he's able to generate here. I'm not advocating you need a golf swing that's that long to go play, but if you can get angles like that, you'll definitely pick up some distance. But the thing we want to talk about here today is look at the right leg angle. Quite a bit of inward leaning angle right there that he can push off of or fall away from, so to speak. Now I'm also going to go to a piece of video here from a pretty familiar player to everyone. I have Ben Hogan right here. Look at the right leg right from the setup. We've got that as an 80 degree angle, so basically 10 degrees of inward leaning angle in the right leg. Play it to the top of the backswing. Notice we still have at least the 80 degrees. Let me rewind this slightly. And watch this transition. He's going to sort of push off the right leg, falling inward towards the target, and then into an impact position. So let's come back live and walk through that. So what we want to create, imagine a baseball pitcher up on the mound, going to go into the windup. Essentially, that move to the home plate is falling off of the mound. You know, imagine that windup falling towards that catcher. That's our transition in the golf swing. As he's falling, his pitching arm is still often moving backward, creating the lag and the stretch that you can't really generate any other way. So as we're going into our backswing, let's look at what we're going to do here. We're not going to pause or stop at the top. There's no place we stop motion. We're going to coil around the inside of this right leg, one piece to waist high, pushing away, generating that hinge. Now we're going to begin to sort of slightly fall into the left side. Now we're going to do that as the club and arms are still going up, and we can create some downloading or some down cocking of the golf club and potentially hinge the wrist even greater than we can naturally do on our own. So I'll kind of put that sort of semi-slow motion here for you. You can see the club fall in right there. I begin to change direction here in the base, and we see additional wrist cock coming to the wrist coming down from the side. Now you can see the golf club sort of slots nicely, flattens on plane. Of course, I'm depending on this right elbow to be down the whole time. I'm trying to tuck it right in front of this right hip as I begin this sort of compressive squat shift towards the target. Okay, so these are some things you need to get your sequencing right. You want to maximize that lag, and then you want to maintain it. And one of those feelings is going to have to be bracing the right leg so that you can have this feeling of a fall into the golf ball or a shift as we start that downswing. And you want to do that as the club is floating and maybe still moving upward right here. Now, getting into pre-impact, we've got the right elbow tucked in front of the hip. And I'm going to say that as a position for players that are, again, trying to generate maximum leverage and power. I know there are plenty of players that will put the right elbow beside the hip. In Jim Hardy's work on the one-plane and two-plane golf swings, a lot of the one-planers will put it on the side of the body and turn out of the way. I think that you're going to do better generating as much leverage and angle and sort of conservation of angular momentum, if you want a $10 word here, from the elbow and wrist coupled up with the turning and clearing of your body. So if you can get the elbow in front, I encourage that. You're going to hold more angle that way. All right, pre-impact. We've driven the legs laterally, right elbow tucked down in front of the body. You can see the right arm under the left arm here. And now I want to start this clearing process. Knees forward, hips forward. And we're going to leave it right here, and we'll start getting into some more things into the next video. But main thing I want you to get out of this one, you've already done the grip, you've already got the lag, you want to be doing things that maintain it. Worst place you can be, lose the right leg, you're at the top of the backswing with the core of your body shifted over. Now you cannot push off here, your spine is tilted the wrong way, essentially going to be coming over the top and quite likely casting or falling back away as your spine angle would increase going back into the target. Just not efficient for generating power. At a minimum, you might create the same amount of swing speed but hit the ball sideways. But worse yet, I think you would actually lose some power and speed. So brace that leg, push off, create some lag as you change direction. Remember, the club may still be going up as you begin to press into the feet and push forward. Do those things for now. Start to train that. In slow motion, I would generally work my way up to the top. Picture trying to leave the club at the top of the swing. Leave the chest facing this way. Start the squat move with the legs. I don't want to start turning yet from the upper half. Spine angle is going to be leaning slightly away from the target. You'll notice the right leg braced inward, upper body angled away. Starting down, squat, press into the feet, shift. Golf club and arms are going to drop. If anything, this angle will get narrower as we start down. Right there. That's that first move. Leaning leg, falling into the target, drive down and lag. And that's going to load us up for that pre-impact position where we'll begin to talk about how the body is finally going to begin to clear out. We'll let the hips clear and we'll talk about release, but we'll do that in a future video here. Okay, I hope those things help you get more speed, power, and distance in your golf swing. Until next time, I'm Herman Williams, and you've just been Hermanized.